So nothing weird happened on that show at all.
The venue was awesome. It was an amazing crowd.
There was a woman during Brett's set who seemed to answer the jokes. Brett would tell a joke and then she would comment on it.
I can't get into a brain with somebody like that.
Like she was a dumb person in a horror film.
I gave enough of a pause and she decided to take that moment and yell out.
I expect that during one of Brett's jokes, the woman would just be like, "Do not go in there."
Okay, I don't know what you said, but I don't care. Hey, when I miss signals, that's the worst. I was flirting with a girl recently. She's like, "You're so good with your words. I wonder what else you're good with." I was like, "Computers." Thank you. Human game show sound.
There was part of me that wanted to go like, you know who's on next, right?
I thought Brett handled her really well, and I was pretty sure it would be over. I'm kidding, I knew that there was no way she would shut up.
I'm kidding, I knew Brett could handle her. Did she know you? Like, was she familiar with you?
No, I think she came with someone else.
Oh, that's why.
I love your slogan. I love Keep Louisville Weird. I love that so much. Because, like it's a fucking problem that it won't be. Like, there's a moment where, like, it's getting too normal now. Like, Houston is not like, "Keep Houston hot." It's like, no, it's fucking hot. I want to tell you guys this. I decided I should be more optimistic. Also, whoever's phone is going for that long. No, I know it is now, and years work. The first two or three rings, I was like, people make mistakes. But after like four, I was like, fucking shut it off. How big is your purse that it took you that long to get to your phone? I was like, well, first let me get these encyclopedias out of the way. Now here's all my groceries. The Lost Ark of the Covenant, okay. What?
She's been part of the act twice now.
She's been part of the act. Oh, was she the one that commented on Brett's? Of course she was. Of course she was. Miss, I don't know if you know what I'm known for, but you're gonna have to stop quickly. So as I was saying, I've decided I should be more of an optimist, although I'm not sure anymore.
There's nothing I can add that you don't already know seeing that clip. I mean, everything is just like her being annoying and you shutting it down and then taking it to like a very, very funny level of like, you know, without being unnecessarily mean, but just mean enough that she deserves it.
Is that a different person this time? Okay, yeah, the one that before was like, "That wasn't fucking me, that was someone else." Alright, this is the warning shot. Don't fucking respond to shit. This is a rhetorical set. Monologue. So, I'm in the airport.
When I realized she wasn't gonna stop, I was just like, fuck it. Let's let the rest of the show be about this.
It was just fun to watch.
And I'm not saying if you have kids, you can't fly with your kids. Obviously, you got kids, you gotta fly with your kids. What I am saying is make a fucking effort. That's all I ask. Just make an effort.
Amen.
There are a lot of laws in the sky. And yes, it's you again. It's weird because she's like Heckler agreeing. Like, she just amened a joke, which is like a positive thing, but also, and if it was the first time you had talked, I'd been like, yeah, amen to that. But it's the third fucking thing, and so. I don't know if you know this, but you're about a day and a half early for church, so. Do you do that in church too? What?
I'll take it, right?
What'd you say?
I didn't say nothing.
You didn't say nothing? Well, that's a first. I'm glad you're switching it up from time to time. That's good. It keeps me guessing. Keeps me on my toes. That's good. I didn't say nothing. How about we keep that up for a while? How about we play a little car game and see who can go the longest without talking? Do you have kids, miss? You see, now she's shutting the fuck up. Now she's learned. Here's what that just was. That was a gazelle being really fucking annoying to a lion. And the lion finally turns, and the gazelle's like, ooh. Grazing away.
You don't know me very well.
What?
None.
Yeah, you're right. She just got up and won. I just killed her with a look. I had no idea I had these powers. I feel like the first half of the first Spider-Man movie where he's like learning about all his powers. Like I just found out I could jump between buildings now. And now anyone who starts with me from now on, I'm just gonna be like, it's not gonna work. I'm gonna be like, maybe it's only in Louisville. Maybe it's only in Louisville. Okay. You know, I don't think I want to finish that story because it's too, here's the thing, because like in an environment like this, like, okay, so the Your Tour goes to all kinds of different places. We've done shows in some of the weirdest venues. We did a show earlier this week in a barbecue joint with a kitchen behind us. We did a show in a pizza place. We did a show in like this weird dance club. And then I come here and I see this setup and I was like, this is fucking fantastic. We got people, everybody's facing front, it's perfect, the lighting's great, the stage is great, the audio is great, this is gonna be fucking awesome. And then you guys are like, no. We're gonna still make it weird. My favorite part is that woman's friends, some of them were out there, and then she left, and you guys came the fuck back in here. That's how annoying she is. And even the people that came with her was like, oh, we can go back in now. Okay, we can go back in. We were afraid to be associated with her before. And I know you guys well. Like, I see the comments on YouTube, I get the emails, I read the Facebook messages, and a lot of you guys say the same thing. You're like, man, I'm not gonna heckle you on the show, but I really wanna see it happen. Like, a lot of you guys say the same thing. Fucking, this is, you're welcome. And, although I can't take credit for that, I wasn't the one that gave her the meth. Like, I can't take credit. What part of Indiana is she from? Her friend just gave me the thumbs up. I fucking nailed it. Did I nail it? Not really, we thought it was funny. Okay, where are you guys from?
South End.
South End. South End of Louisville, like by airport South End?
Yeah.
Okay, did she work at the... Oh, welcome back. Come on in. They've heard so much about you. Okay, so this is the part that you know now, not anymore, right? Okay. Oh, and you're hugging him. Are you guys together? Are you guys married?
Yeah.
You guys are married. How long have you been married?
We're not married.
Are you not married? Well, keep this up and you won't be. It's gonna be great. She's gonna give every speech at the wedding. Best man's gonna get up there. She's like, no, I have something to say. How long have you guys been dating?
Two years.
Two She said 2 years, he said 2.5 years. Well, this I have to investigate. And by the way, if you think that I'm talking to you for too long, you ever hear of like when a parent has a kid smoking, and they're like, you're smoking a cigarette, well now you're gonna have to smoke a case of them, so you'd be sick of this shit. Well, here's what happens when you want attention. So... How did you two meet?
I don't even want to know.
That's so weird, because I asked, and I'm me, so... I would have thought that I knew. But that is right, you do seem to know everything, so... Oh, I love that he just applauded. He's like, you fucking nailed it, buddy. You nailed it. Ain't that right? If you don't, she does. No, she's actually been pretty quiet. She's been, even now, she's like, you fucking know. Alright, Stripes, what's your name? Chad and Kathy, what's your name? What's your name?
Teresa.
Teresa, okay. Well, if you said no? You know, what the fuck? They have no idea what your name is.
Teresa hurt all
life. Hold on a second. Is this the worst witness protection program of all time? Yeah, they shipped you here because they were afraid you'd talk. All right. We've had enough of this. Let's get back to whatever the fuck is happening. Teresa, no. No. Talk again, I'm gonna have someone roll up a newspaper. Nothing from any of you from here on out, whether it's from Teresa or her boyfriend or her sponsors. Show now.
We love you.
I appreciate that, but let's love me from afar. And you love me the way that I love porn, silently and ashamed, by myself at home. So, all right, you know what? Fuck it. I can't get back into material after this. Here's how I'm gonna run the rest of the show. So if you guys enjoy my show, I have six different comedy albums. They're all material you did not hear tonight, because how could you have? They're all different from each other. If you want to pick up one, normally they're $10 a piece. But if you want all six of them, here's what I do on the Your Tour. You can get all six for 20, and here's why I do that. Because if you want to say, hey Steve, I support what it is that you do, here's $20, least I can do is give you 5.5 hours of entertainment. Or, if you have a really slow friend, it could be like 30 hours of entertainment. You should get them, you can speak along with them at home. So, if you want to pick up the albums, great, but I got free shit for you too. I already got, you already paid to see the show, so I got posters and stickers, and I think you got them on your way in. You have little cards with all my social media on them, like my Reddit and Instagram and Snapchat and YouTube and Facebook and Twitter, and not MySpace though, not anymore. I used to be on MySpace. Everybody was on MySpace. And MySpace still exists. I don't know if you know that, but it's still here. Vine was like, we're done. MySpace is like, we're hanging on! Like, you understand how weird that is? MySpace is the thing. I had 500,000 people on my MySpace. And so I decided it would be fun to post a status and see if anyone would read it. That's how you met your husband? Okay. What? I think Teresa's a ventriloquist now. We're going to get to the crowd participation part in just a moment. That's how you met your husband. Hopefully, at least, like 10 years ago, right? 11 years ago. Yeah, because that's when people were on MySpace. So that's an okay time to have met your husband. If you met your husband on MySpace now, then your husband is a programmer for MySpace. What? Okay, love that cute, smart guy. He's just like, shut the fuck up. Which is how I know you've been together 11 years, because he can be like, shut the fuck up. Meanwhile, Teresa's boyfriend is like, I just hope this ends soon. I can't say a thing about it. All I have to do is root for the best and stay outside as long as she's in the room. But here's what I want to do from this point out in the show. Now it's going to be Q&A. You can ask me anything you want, as ridiculous as you want, as personal as you want. We'll see where the fuck this goes. I have a feeling we're in Louisville. It's going to get pretty fucking weird. So you can pull this in any direction you want it to go. We're going to choose your own adventure for the rest of the show. You guys want to play? Yeah. Of course, Teresa has her fucking hand up. I'll get to you later. You have a question. What do you got? Teresa, we've talked about this. Teresa's boyfriend, what's your name?
Trent.
Trent?
No.
Trent? You're the most important person in this show right now. Okay? You will keep this show on task. I don't give a fuck if it destroys your relationship, but you're gonna help. What's your question in the back? What do you got?
Have I been to the Derby?
Have I been to the Kentucky Derby? I have not. I have not. I will. Fuck you, boo! I didn't say I have not. I don't want to. I have not because I hadn't been able to afford it, and then I got busy.
You want tickets to Oaks?
Wait, what the hell else do I have to do? You bought tickets to see what I have to do. Cheap. Okay, so are you then. So, I would like to go to the Derby if anybody has extra tickets for next year, because this year I will be in Australia.
What do I have to do?
So, who else you got over there? What do you got? Oh, you want me to read you the bio on my dating profile? Fuck yeah, let's do this. Well, this is new. Alright, this is my Bumble bio. Oh my god, I matched with Teresa? Trent, I'm so sorry. I'm kidding. That's a hard left. Anyway, so... No, that was mean of me. There's nothing hard about that. And so... So here's my Bumble profile. 6'4", living my dream, and wonderful at making lists. Which, by the way, it's a little joke, because I make a list, and everybody on that makes lists, and then sometimes people message, and they're like, what's your favorite list to make? One of other girls. I said, my dog, Walter, is my favorite. I travel for work. I'm a stand-up comedian, and I'm forced to live 3 days at a time. Walter is cool with it. One. It's Teresa Light. This is amazing. It's Teresa 2, Electric Boogaloo. So, the reason I put that in my profile, that I'm forced to live like 3 days at a time, that's big. What did. Did you not know that you were rummaging through your purse while your phone was going on? Was that. You didn't know you were I wasn't really making fun of you as much as I was using it to make fun of Teresa Mark. So. I said, don't worry about it, MySpace, we good, alright? We met each other on MySpace. Oh, I knew that from earlier. Were you not at the show before when you said that? I could have sworn you were here when you said that, so. Even Teresa is like, I don't even know what the fuck that was. That was... Keep Houston hot. So, it's the best. It's that phone's going off again. Holy shit. Sir, do you wish you would have ended up with Tom or? I feel like I could go on forever with you guys, but I'm not gonna because the tickets were cheap. And so, I'm fine with it. Don't worry, Teresa will be doing a show in the parking lot after the show. What do you do for a living, Teresa?
I'm a telemarketer.
You're a telemarketer. Yeah, I knew it, not you. No wonder you talk so much, because your whole job is getting hung up on. Your entire job is people going, fucking shut up. So then she's like, I'm going to take that into the show. I'm going to take that into the show. What do you telemarket for?
I sell screen printing inks.
You sell screen printing inks.
Yeah, what kind of...
That's super specific. Wait, you said what kind of... Oh, you're trying to pitch me on your services now.
What kind of ink is your shirt screened with?
What kind of ink is my shirt screened with? I don't fucking care. I'm not going to use yours. There wasn't a second where I was like, give me the pitch, give me the pitch. Wait, no, ahead, go ahead. Give me the pitch.
I'm done.
No. Tell me why your stuff is better. I'm going to interrupt it. I'm sorry, is that annoying at your job? I apologize. That is every comic's sick dream, by the way. What just happened? What I just got to do. I had a ton of fun tonight. It was weird, but it was fun. And the thing is, like, the your tour really did just start out as this pipe dream. I've been doing stand-up for 15 years, and it's something where, like, every year it gets a little better and a little better. And you always dream of getting to the point where you can just do a show in a random city on a random night and people come out and support it. And this is the first year that that's been able to happen for me.
Yay.
And it's because of you guys. Because you guys come out and support, and you buy the tickets, however cheap they were. You buy the tickets. And you come out and you support the show in such a big way. And I always want, when I start a show, I always hope that the audience has a wonderful time at the beginning of the show. And I'll tell you this, if you had even one-tenth the time that I had, then I know you guys had a great time, because this was so much fun. So, did you guys have a good time?
We have 6 hours to kill on this drive, so I'm just gonna have you keep talking.
So then Steve was doing jokes, and then she interrupted, and Steve was smart, and he said things, and he shut her down the way she deserved, but also he was, like, funny about it and creative.
You're good at this.
Without further ado, I'd like to welcome to the stage one of my favorite comedians, Mr. Steve Hofstetter.
Come on, Steve, you got this.